This piece of Lisa is being brought to you by Mutual Security Credit Union. Find out more at MSCU.com.
Joining us right now is the very exciting, terrifically best-selling novelist Janet Ivanovich. You may know her from the Stephanie Plum novels. She's also written 12 romance novels, the Alexandra Barnaby novels and graphic novels, and a lot of other books, including How I Write Secrets of a Best-Selling Author. Maybe I should pick that one up myself. Welcome, Janet Ivanovich, to the Lisa Wexler Show today. Hello.
Thank you. It's great to be with you.
Sure. So now your latest novel, which is going to be released, which was just released actually a few days ago, is the latest in your series of Stephanie Plum novels. For those of us who are not familiar with Stephanie Plum, who is she and how does she get to have her own series of novels?
Stephanie Plum is a female bounty hunter in Trenton, New Jersey. She works for a bail bondsman who also happens to be her cousin Vinny. And in this book, I've really raised the body count. I had a lot of fun with this book because there's a guy leaving dead bodies all over Trenton, and they have gift tags on them that are addressed to Stephanie Plum. So she's, of course, the fear is that very shortly Stephanie Plum is going to be one of the dead bodies with the gift tag, you know, stuck
right
onto her. Her shirt. So so she has this to worry about, and she also has some personal things going on. She has two hot guys in her life. They've been with her for about 17 books.
Okay.
And which, you know, in the world of Plum, this is a different time frame than most of us operate on. The world of Plum is very condensed.
Okay.
And so she has these two hot guys in her life, and her family and friends think she should make a decision.
And so let me ask you about her, because I've read about Stephanie. I've read Stephanie. I feel like I know her a little bit anyway. And she works for an industry that I would say maybe 15 years ago no one would really know much about. But due to reality TV and the ubiquitousness of people like Dog, everybody feels like they know the bail bondsman's life. When you began writing the Stephanie Plum novels, was that area of business known to the public at all?
No, it really wasn't. And I had been doing romance novels. I did 12 romance novels and decided I wanted to move into crime fiction. And I saw the movie Midnight Run with Charles Grodin and Robert De Niro. And it was about a bounty hunter.
Robert
De Niro was a bounty hunter. And I loved the movie and I loved the idea. I thought Bounty Hunter had a real cachet to it. I didn't know anything about the bail bonds industry. I found out, I did a lot of research after I saw the movie. But there really was, it wasn't out there at the time. It was something new. Dog came along afterwards and a bunch of other shows and, you know, made it a lot more popular.
Because I find that to be, you know, to me, one of the fun things about reading your novels, one of the fun things about reading fiction is you get to find out a little bit of true nonfiction when you read a good novel. I mean, that's part of the fun. You enter into somebody's makeup world or made up world, but really you glean from it a lot of information about stuff you would never put yourself into in real life. And for a woman to be a bail bondsman is already an immediately intriguing character, because it's the furthest thing that you think of when you think of a movie like Midnight Run.
This is true, but when I did my research, what I found is that it really is not uncommon. Probably over 40% of all people in the bail bonds industry are women, and they happen to be very, very good at it. We're used to seeing Dog on the screen, you know, running around in his black leather stuff and banging on doors in the middle of the night, you know, with his gun out and everything. But a lot of the industry, you know, it doesn't happen all that way. Women are especially good at making captures because they don't have all that testosterone. They're more willing to finesse an arrest. They can, you know, track down a guy and go up to him in a bar and sit next to him and get a conversation going, and before he knows it, you know, he's got a cuff on his wrist. And this happens more often than not. Women are actually especially good at a lot of bond enforcement issues.
That's really fascinating. I'm chatting with Janet Ivanovich, best-selling author, and her newest author, the latest Stephanie Plum novel, is called Smokin' 17. And Janet, so let me just ask you this, because you wrote this other book, How I Write Secrets of a Best-Selling Author. Do you write your mystery novels, your crime fiction novels, in a way that you know what the plot is and the underlying resolution before you get to the last chapter, or do they evolve as you write them?
No, I work from an outline, and it's not a very detailed, huge outline, but there are certain things that I have to know before I start the book, and one of them is the basic crime line. I know how the book is going to begin. I know how the book is going to end. I know a few things that are going to happen in the middle of the book, but I always like to know the resolution of the book. I like to have a place to go to. I think that, you can write yourself in a corner very easily if you don't have some kind of a plot line to follow.
And do you do a lot of crime research from police officers, from pathologists, from crime people, or do you do it sitting at your desk from Google? How is it that you imagine all these different scenarios for people dying?
Well, I used to do a lot of research. Early on, I hung out with a lot of fugitive apprehension agents in the bond industry. I talked to a lot of bail bonds agents. I hung out with the Trenton cops, and I still have some really good friends in Trenton, police officers. I don't do quite as much research anymore. As it turned out, the series is very character-driven, and I have a certain body of knowledge behind me now that I can refer back to. But what my readers really care about are the characters.
Yeah.
They like to have a plot. They like to have a little danger. But what they really care about are seeing where the characters are going year after year. And so I don't do as much research as I used to. In the beginning, I went out, I learned how to shoot a gun. I walked around with pepper spray, and a stun gun, just so I would know how Stephanie felt, what it would be like to carry that in my purse. But, I don't do so much of it anymore.
And tell me something, Janet. Why Trenton, New Jersey?
Trenton, New Jersey is a great place. Jersey has so much energy, and it's kind of a caricature. It makes life easy for me. Everyone knows what Jersey is. Even before Snooki, everybody knew Jersey, and, the Sopranos were there. And so it's very good. And Trenton is exactly the right size. It has a river, a place to dump bodies. It has little satellite communities that are little small towns in themselves, which is where Stephanie lives with her family. And but it has the larger element where you would actually expect to find more crime.
Do you live in New Jersey yourself?
I don't. I grew up in Jersey, and we still have lots of relatives there, but I'm in Florida right now.
Oh, that's nice. That's nice. East or West Coast?
Naples, West Coast.
Very nice. Right at the end of Alligator Alley, when my parents, when I make the drive from Boca South to the other end, because my in-laws live in Sarasota. So, right there.
Okay.
Right there. So, Janet, are you going to be coming to Connecticut anytime soon to talk about your book, promote your book, say hello to the people here? You're going to RJ Julia. Are you coming here?
I'm not coming there in the immediate future. I just came back from book tour. And, of course, I was in Jersey. That was the closest that I got this time. I've done Connecticut in the past. They moved me around. I never go to some place twice.
I see. Well, that's a good life. That's a good life. Do you enjoy your career, Janet? Do you enjoy the progress from romance novelist to crime fiction? Are you going to go back to some romance for those of us who miss your romance days? Tell me.
Well, I have a little romance in these books, and especially in this last book. I'm not sure if I'll go back to being a romance writer. I like the mix. I like that I can have, you know, kind of combined genres. Makes it more interesting for me.
Well, terrific. Thank you very much for joining us today, Janet Ivanovich. You've got tons of fans. People love your work. They gobble them up. They wait for the next one. Congratulations with the success of the Stephanie Plum novel series, and particularly with this newest one, Smokin' 17.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You've just been listening to A Piece of Lisa. If you'd like to listen to the whole two-hour show, please go to lisawexler.com, where all shows are archived. And do follow me on Twitter, @LisaWexler. Thanks for listening.